Oh, hello there. I'm Lawrence Kohlberg, Professor of Education and Social Psychology at Harvard University. On October 25th, 1927, I was born in Bronxville, New York, where I attended Phillips Academy in Andover, Massachusetts. I became a merchant marine at the end of World War II, and after that I went to the University of Chicago and received my degree in psychology. I developed a marvelous theory. I came up with the Lawrence Kohlberg stages of moral development. Let's look at morals. Moral. Concerning or relating to what is right and wrong in human behavior. Based on what you think is right and good. Considered right and good by most people, agreeing with a standard of right behavior. I based my theory off of Piaget's work and cultivated into the theory that is widely recognized today. I'll explain further if I can just find my board.
I hypothesize that morals develop through stages over time. Oh yes, perfect.
Well, here's my board. This is my theory, where I have 3 levels and 6 stages. The first level is the pre-conventional level, where judgment is based solely on a person's own needs and perceptions. The second level is the conventional level, where the expectations of society and laws are taken into account. The third level is the post-conventional level, where judgments are based on abstract or personal principles of justice. Each level has 2 stages. Stage 1 is the obedience versus punishment orientation. This is where you obey rules to avoid punishment. Stage 2 is the self-interest orientation. This is where right and wrong is determined by personal needs and wants. Stage 3 is the good boy, good girl orientation. This follows social norms and conformity. Stage 4 is the law and order orientation. Laws must be obeyed to maintain social order. Stage 5 is the social contract orientation. Morals are determined by socially agreed upon standards. And the final stage, stage 6, is the universal ethical principles orientation. There are universal principles of human dignity and social justice that individuals should uphold, no matter what the law or other people say. Let's dive into some dilemmas. To categorize the stages, I told children and adults scenarios or moral dilemmas. Put on some music. How they respond to the dilemma determines what stage of moral reasoning they are in. Checkmate. Let's look at a simple moral dilemma. There has been a murder. 2 men are on trial. One is definitely guilty, and the other is innocent. You have 2 choices. Do you put them both in jail, or do you let them both free? Now suppose 3 men are on trial for a murder. 2 are definitely guilty, and 1 is definitely innocent. You have 2 choices. You put them all in prison, or you let them all free. What do you do? Now imagine 99 guilty and one innocent. Do you imprison them all, or do you let them all free? The Heinz Dilemma is the most popular one I use for my study. It goes like this. There's a man and his sick wife. He basically can't afford the medicine that will cure her. There are three choices. A. Not steal the medicine because stealing is wrong. This would be considered in the pre-conventional stage. He should B. Steal the medicine and receive punishment. This is the conventional stage. Or C. Steal the medicine without any consequences. This is the post-conventional stage. Wasn't that delightful? Vote for me, Lawrence Kohlberg, in my theory, Stages of Moral Development. You can use my theory when talking about children sharing or distributing materials. The stages can guide you in knowing how students will react and follow rules, whether it be in classroom rules or rules of a game. It will also help you anticipate cheating from your students. Thank you, and good night.